So when did you start as a Stadtman investigator?
I started in 2012, January, at NINDS. So my name is Wei Lu. I'm a tenure-track Stadtman investigator at National Institute of Neurological Disorders and a stroke.
Let me ask you a question about being a Stadtman investigator. Do you find that that's helped you connect with people throughout the NIH?
Certainly. I'm in the neuroscience community, and the neuroscience have a different institute, have neuroscience programs, not only NINDS, National Institute of Mental Health, also many other institutes. They have regular seminars and also have different social activities sometimes, so which it really helps.
Todd, you decided to apply to NICHD, to an intramural research program. Why did you do that? Why coming to intramural NIH research program versus another academic center?
Sure. Well, I think that starting out an independent position at the NIH is really terrific because it really provides you with tremendous resources to get your lab up and running. And you get to spend a lot more time focusing on the people you want to hire to start your lab with, but also to really focus on the science. The major thing that we have the opportunity to do here the major thing that we don't have to do here is write grants. And this actually provides a lot more time for focusing your effort on the bench, training scientists, and actually pushing forward your science. And I can say that even after 2 years here, I still spend a significant amount of time at the bench, and this is what I really love to do. So I think this would have been very hard in a more traditional academic institution where such a significant portion of your time is spent basically trying to obtain funding. My name is Todd McFarlane. I'm a tenure-track investigator at the National Institute of Child Health and Human Development. And I came in through the Stadtman investigator search 2 years ago.
How many people have been hired through the Stadtman searches?
So since we started in 2009, we've hired 39 people. There are still several people in negotiations from the 2013 application cohort. We typically hire about 8 to 11 per year, and this now represents about one-third of our tenure track hires. And our Stadtman investigators now are about 15% of our total tenure track investigators.
My name is Nihal, Altan, Bonnet. I'm a Stadtman investigator at the National Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute.
Nihal, if you were going to encourage someone to apply to the Stadtman search, what would you tell them?
Well, at other institutions where you could be going into one department, say the biochemistry department or the cell biology department or developmental biology department, those kinds of borders, definitions don't exist here. So at a heart, lung, blood institute, you could be working on development, you can be working on infectious diseases, you could be working on cell biology, basic biochemistry, structural biology, all of those things could be in one institute. So, and that means practically you as an investigator have access to those human and material resources that again, at other institutions would not be possible. So I think I would have the candidate who's applying for a Stadtman investigator think about those possibilities and think about how that kind of an environment, a rich environment, would benefit their research, their vision for the next few years.
So Audrey, tell me, what was the application process like? I know it's a little bit different than, perhaps more traditional academic type of application. So what was your take on that?
Yeah, so I applied to several academic positions and I applied to the Stadtman. So that really allows me to compare and contrast to two different processes. So the Stadtman is really a multi-level process, which is basically two phases. So there's the written phase where you send in your application. It's supposed to be a transformative research idea, high risk, high impact. And then there's a series of oral presentations where you come to the campus and you actually defend your proposal. So I would say it's a very multi-level process. It's a very positive process, but it's more multi-level than the traditional university academic process.
Hello, I'm Audray Harris. I'm a Stadtman investigator. I'm a tenure track investigator at NIH, Laboratory of Infectious Diseases.
Yeah, and if I can add to, I think for some of the sections, depending on what they are and how many applicants they are, it ends up also involving kind of a symposium-like day where we actually invite many of our applicants that we are very interested in. So they could be a symposium day of about 6 to 10 people coming together, giving short presentation, meeting with the search committee as well as with people at the NIH that may be interested in. And then from that, there's a selection process for Stadtman candidates. So that's a little bit different, I think, than what people are used to. But my experience has been that actually people end up really liking it at the end of the day because it's quite dynamic. It's quite intense. They end up meeting wonderful people.
Yes, it's
which,
great for networking.
Yeah, exactly, for networking. And then perhaps these people will end up being their colleagues because actually there's more than one position for. So it's not as if there's only one position. So then, you know, you may at least, you know, you may find that one person you interviewed it with all is also a Stadtman the following year, which is kind of nice.
So what attracted you to apply to the Stadtman and to come to the IRP specifically?
Well, I didn't know that much about the NIH IRP, to be honest. My background a long time ago was in physics, so I didn't really, never in my life did I see myself at the National Institutes of Health. But, you know, my research sort of drifted first into biophysics and then cell biology. And then when I was looking for faculty positions, I was encouraged by someone in the program to apply to this. And I made a number of visits at that time, and the more visits I made, the more I liked the place. And my name is Dan Larson. I'm an investigator in the National Cancer Institute, and I arrived as a Stadtman investigator in 2011, and the name of my lab is the section on the systems biology of gene expression. And quite frankly, I think in the area that I'm working in, which is on gene expression and chromosome biology, it's really just one of the best places in the world.
It's a cutting edge, yes, yes.
Yeah.
So so you would say that what I explained before, that coming and being exposed, that being able to come repeatedly and being able to interact with different possible options of places where that are going to be your home is one of the pluses of this of the system, right?
Well, absolutely. So I was, in fact, sort of interacting with two different institutes. So NIDDK and NCI were both places where I could see myself fitting and my research fitting. And so seeing both sides of that, seeing two different institutes, seeing different labs, I think was really helpful for me. And also, I think the main asset of the NIH, and certainly one of the things that attracted me, is I just felt the investigators I met were thoughtful and collegial and really lucid and creative, and so seeing more investigators, more lab heads, more scientists was just really inspiring.